die Tore weit und die Türen in der Welt hoch, dass der König der Ehren einziehe. Wer ist der König der Ehre? Es ist der Herr, stark und mächtig, der Herr mächtig im Streit. Fliegen weite geht's, open die ancient doors, and the King of Glory will come in. Who is this King of Glory? He is the Lord Almighty. He is the King of Glory.
Welcome to our bilingual Christmas Eve service. Together we want to celebrate the coming of the Messiah and feel the joy of Christmas. We hope and pray that you will enjoy this video service. We are thankful for the opportunity to connect with you. We are grateful that we can celebrate two Christmas Eve services in our church. We pray that we can soon return to a more normal routine and wish you God's blessings. Herzlich willkommen zu der Christfesper am Heiligen Abend. Gemeinsam wollen wir die Geburt Jesu feiern und uns von der Liebe Gottes anstecken lassen, selbst Liebe weiterzugeben. Wir feiern unseren Gottesdienst zweisprachig, damit wir alle gemeinsam die frohe Botschaft hören und uns freuen können. Wir bitten um Gottes Segen für diesen Gottesdienst und wünschen Ihnen allen ein gesegnetes Weihnachten. Gemeinsam beten wir. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of true light. Grant that we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence and share it wherever possible. We ask for your blessings for this Christmas season and for every new day. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Prophet Jesaja kündigte die Geburt Jesu an. Das Volk, das im Finstern wandelt, sieht ein großes Licht. Und über denen, die da wohnen im finsteren Lande, scheint es hell. Denn uns ist ein Kind geboren, ein Sohn ist uns gegeben, und die Herrschaft ruht auf seiner Schulter. Und er heißt Wunderrat, ewig Vater, Friedefürst. Auf dass seine Herrschaft groß werde und des Friedens kein Ende auf dem Thron Davids und in seinem Königreich. Dass er es stärke und stütze durch Recht und Gerechtigkeit, von nun an bis in Ewigkeit.
The prophet Isaiah announced the birth of Jesus with the following words. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of power, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. Amen.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register.
Thank you. Galiläa, aus der Stadt Nazareth, in das jüdische Land zur Stadt Davids, die da heißt Bethlehem, weil er aus dem Hause und Geschlechte Davids war, damit er sich schätzen ließe mit Maria, seinem vertrauten Weibe, die war schwanger. Und als sie dort waren, kam die Zeit, dass sie gebären sollte. Und sie gebar ihren ersten Sohn und wickelte ihn in Windeln und legte ihn in eine Krippe, denn sie hatten sonst keinen Raum in der Herberge.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
In derselben Gegend, auf dem Felde bei den Hürden, die hüteten des Nachts ihre Herde. Und der Engel des Herrn trat zu ihnen, und die Klarheit des Herrn leuchtete um sie, und sie fürchteten sich sehr. Und der Engel sprach zu ihnen: Fürchtet euch nicht! Siehe, ich verkündige euch große Freude, die allem Volk widerfahren wird. Denn euch ist heute der Heiland geboren, welcher ist Christus der Herr in der Stadt Davids. Und das habt zum Zeichen, ihr werdet finden das Kind in Windeln gewickelt und in einer Krippe liegen. Und alsbald war da bei dem Engel die Menge der himmlischen Heerscharen, die lobten Gott und sprachen: Ehre sei Gott in der Höhe, und Friede auf Erden bei den Menschen seines Wohlgefallens.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy, that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Today, we hear the word of the prophet Micah, who announced the coming of the Messiah. The Lord says, "Bethlehem, Ephrathah, you are one of the smallest towns in Judah, but out of you I will bring a ruler for Israel, whose family line goes back to ancient times, and he will bring peace." Dear sisters and brothers in Jesus Christ, Bethlehem was a small town where people knew each other and some were related to one another. Many centuries ago, King David was born in Bethlehem. He was the youngest of his siblings, still almost a child, when he was taken from his father's flocks and anointed as king by the prophet Samuel. David was one of the greatest kings in the history of the people of Israel. Everything important starts small. From very small seeds grow plants and later produce flowers and then a lot of food. God gives his blessings. It is a pleasure for us to see plants or trees grow. Peace also starts small. It begins where two people love each other and pass on their love. Love grows in the family, in the neighborhood, in the circles of friends and community. Peace grows where people meet without prejudice and enjoy taking care of one another. We are all needed for this. Today on Christmas Eve, we remember that God's peace came to us when he sent his Son into our world. The life of the Messiah began quietly and simply in a stable. Jesus was born in the small town of Bethlehem, not in Jerusalem, as many, including the kings from the east, imagined. People who were considered lowly learned of Jesus' birth first. The shepherds received the good news, welcomed the child, and shared everything that they had learned and seen with others. His mother Mary, chosen by God, was a simple woman, one of many young women of the people of Israel. Even she did not see herself as something special. To the angel's message that she will be the mother of the Messiah, she simply answered, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." In today's time, we often expect that the important changes will come from the rulers of the world, that governments may decide that peace will finally come, and that many things will change for the better. We have many hopes and expectations. The Christmas message directs our view and our thinking into a different direction. There is a small beginning, then it grows bigger, and all of a sudden something new and better becomes visible. Other people become aware of it, learn more about it, like it, and make it known to others. We understand that it is up to us to change something for the better. There are many different opportunities. It is important that we do not give up on good ideas and dreams, but continue to develop them and carry them forward. Everything starts small. Through God's blessings, something can grow bigger than we ever imagined. I found this word of wisdom by the Brazilian writer Paulo Coelho. Understand that you must pay attention to the small things. Only those who do so can change the world. Understand that you must pay attention to the small things. Only those who do so can change the world. Surely even Martin Luther would not have thought that his conclusions that we are saved by God's grace alone and that we are forgiven through Jesus would trigger such a great change in his time. First, it was a liberating experience for himself. His thoughts were shared, understood, and accepted by others. As a result, the Reformation expanded and brought a new freedom to people throughout the world and even into our time. Throughout the history, many people have experienced that new and special things have developed through dreams, ideas, and thoughts. Especially selfless people who spend endless time to serve others have become an example for us. Let us think about another topic, our good and sometimes lifelong friendships. Everything started with a first encounter, a short conversation, a question, or a smile. This first small beginning can turn into a close relationship that we enjoy throughout the years. We can never be thankful enough for our friends and for all that we experience and share with one another. Another example is the carol Silent Night, Stille Nacht, which is such an integral part of Christmas Eve. It was actually meant as a temporary solution. 203 years ago, it was written and sung on Christmas Eve in Oberstdorf in Austria, because the organ was broken. A simple song that could be accompanied on the guitar was needed quickly at that time. Certainly, neither Joseph Mohr, who wrote the text, nor Franz Xaver Gruber, who composed the music, nor the congregation that sang it for the first time thought that it could once become such an important song. New hymns are usually not the most beloved songs right away, because they have to be learned first. After the Christmas Eve service in 1818, the song sheet with the carol remained at the organ and was nearly forgotten. Years later, it was found, and then the hymn was sung in Austria and Germany and later all over the world. Today it is almost impossible not to sing Stille Nacht, Silent Night on Christmas Eve, or at least listen to it. Until today it has been translated in more than 320 languages. A small song has become something big, and nobody had expected that. Earlier, we heard the words of the prophet Isaiah. The little child is the wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, whose reign will have no end. Even though these words seem way too big for a newborn child, we know that they have come true through Jesus' life, death, and resurrection. At Christmas, many of us think back to their childhood. It is the time when we were small and perceived many things differently. We should try to marvel again, just as children do, that we can see many small things as something amazing and do everything with devotion. Christmas is the time, the celebration of love, where we like to exchange meaningful gifts, share God's love, and celebrate with one another. It is essential to be attentive and see the uniqueness in every person. It is a special gift when we tell someone how important they are to us, when we surprise someone with a visit, when we reach out for reconciliation, or when we are simple here for one another. There are many ways, dreams, and ideas that make the lives of other people special and help us to celebrate Christmas with thankful hearts. We ask for God's blessings that we may be filled with Christmas joy and peace. We pray that we can radiate the love that came into our world through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And the peace of God, which transcends all our understanding, will guard our hearts and minds in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Du Mensch gewordener Gott, du liebst uns und beschenkst deine Welt. Du bist ein kleines Kind geworden. So bitten wir dich um Liebe für alle Kinder dieser Welt, dass sie in Frieden groß werden.
Lord Jesus, help us to remember that you were born in a stable and cradled in a manger. Keep us from longing for wealth, comfort, ease and luxury, which you never enjoyed.
Maria und Josef waren bei Jesu Geburt auf sich allein gestellt. So bitten wir dich für alle Einsamen, dass ihnen dieses Fest nicht zur Qual, sondern zur Freude wird. Besonders beten wir für alle, die einen lieben Menschen verloren haben.
Lord Jesus, help us to remember that there was no room for you in the inn. Grant that our lives may never become so crowded that there is no room in them for you or for people who need us.
Die Hirten sind von ihrer nächtlichen Arbeit aufgebrochen und haben dich gesucht. So bitten wir dich für alle, die in diesen Tagen arbeiten, dass sie Dank und weihnachtliche Freude erfahren.
Lord Jesus, help us to remember that to you there came the shepherds and the wise men. Grant that learned and simple, high and humble, great and small, may be joined in worshiping and loving you.
Die Hirten haben von deiner Geburt berichtet. So bitten wir dich für uns und unsere Brüder und Schwestern in Jesus Christus in aller Welt, dass wir die Weihnachtsfreude teilen können und füreinander da sind, wo wir gebraucht werden. Segne und behüte uns und unsere Lieben, damit wir alle in deiner Liebe leben können.
Lord Jesus, help us to remember that you grew up in an ordinary home, went to school and worked at a carpenter's shop. Grant that we may think no task too humble and too common for our hands to touch when you, the Lord of glory, lived among the common things. Amen.
Let us pray the Lord's Prayer in German or English. Vater unser im Himmel, geheiligt werde dein Name, dein Reich komme, dein Wille geschehe, wie im Himmel, so auf Erden. Unser tägliches Brot gib uns heute und vergib uns unsere Schuld, wie auch wir vergeben unseren Schuldigern. Und führe uns nicht in Versuchung, sondern erlöse uns von dem Bösen. Denn dein ist das Reich und die Kraft und die Herrlichkeit in Ewigkeit. Amen.
Nun geht in Frieden und bringt den Frieden zu anderen. Gott ermächtigt euch, seine Boten zu sein. Andere wollen von euch hören, was ihr von Gott gehört habt. Ihr könnt anderen tun, was Gott an euch getan hat. So wird sein Wort zu eurem Wort, sein Werk zu eurem Werk. Der Herr sei mit euch allen. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Im Namen des Vaters und des Sohnes und des Heiligen Geistes. Amen.